And, you know, it's individual person burning books in her house because she doesn't want them anymore and she doesn't want other people to be subjected to the stupid messages that they put across. You know, that's permissible, I think. I don't agree with it. And I'll tell you why right now. This is a book, and I use that in the loosest terms. Just like the three books that Cassie burned, this book was a gift to me. And believe it or not, it was as a joke on my 27th birthday. I was given The Audacity of Hope, a fine piece of literature from our current commander-in-chief. I read this thing cover to cover, not once, not twice, but three times. And I was really the dumber for it. Let's just say that instead of calling this The Audacity of Hope, they should have called it The Verbosity of Tripe, because what we have here is a lot of nonsense, basically. It's words strung together into constructive, you know, nice little constructs that might little work in, you know, some far-off distant universe where A is actually B. But when you try to get into the particulars with this, you're lost. And to be fair, this is true of just about any president's writing for the past several decades. I don't think I've written any memoirs from any recent presidents that have been, you know, fairly entertaining or fairly informative. But I don't really see the need to burn this. And the reason is because it's become sort of a memento. I definitely would not recommend reading this because I'd like you to keep all of your functioning brain cells intact. But I will say that every time when I look at this picture and this title, I have a smile on my face for some reason. And that is because I'm reminded of how sorry a state we're in right now, how we got here, and how we all kind of volunteered for what we're in right now. I mean, when you think about it, we've all really just sort of gone along with it. We've contributed to it. I mean, if whether you voted for this guy or the other guy who was older and maybe not as much of a hunk or not as quick with the ladies or the guys, depending on which story you believe. But you basically participated with the system. And the system creates crap like this, the people who push it, and the people who turn it into policy when they get your vote. So, I like to keep mementos. Cassie likes to burn stuff. But I think we're both trying to get to the same place here. The people on Cassie's channel that are currently recommending that she should be institutionalized, that's kind of hard to stomach and that's kind of hard to justify. And the truth is that in many ways we are becoming like the Nazis. Our culture is very much changing. We have an entire generation of young people that speak with their votes rather than with their heads. And naturally, when you speak with your heads, the votes follow, and they follow to things that are actually much better. I mean, there's no real way to justify 2 years ago the same people who were railing like crazy at all of the illegal wars and everything, now suddenly standing down and saying, you know something, these wars were terrible, but now it's our guy in office, so we have to make them our own, these wars. They are ours now, and we have to make the best of them. We have to make sure that the genocide runs more smoothly. There's a little bit of facetiousness to what I'm saying, but that doesn't take away from the carnage that's going on just across the Atlantic, a few thousand miles past the Mediterranean. It's pretty ugly over there. But, you know, we're too busy worrying about a few books. A book written by probably the dumbest blonde in existence. fattest Irish piece of sloppy garbage to ever trudge the streets of Detroit. And a smooth-talking, slick with the guys and the gals, Pimp Daddy, who's telling us all, baby, I know I beat you up good, but it's going to be all right. Now hit them streets and get me another score. Again, being facetious, but I'm in that kind of mood tonight because, quite frankly, guys, I can't really stomach this anymore. Can't go along with it anymore, you know? Can't really endorse the system. Got to do what's right. And right now, what's doing right is just speaking my mind in somewhat of an erratic fashion, but nonetheless, speaking it. So why don't some of you speak yours? Tell me if I'm wrong on this. Is it okay to burn books if it's your property and you're making a point and to film it and to laugh about it? Because I think under certain circumstances it's permissible. And do you think that maybe we're a little too focused on calling each other Nazis and a little less focused on what Nazism actually entails and what parts of it we're actually embodying and which parts we aren't? Love to get your feedback on that. Until then, with prudence to myself and benevolence to all of you, good evening.